Welcome to In Hindsight, where we showcase local New Mexico. We also debate on the hot topics. And are you the a-hole? And I am your host, Dave.
I'm your co-host, Rhea.
And we have our guest,
Marcus.
Yay! So it's summer in New Mexico, and there's a lot of events going on. One of the events that actually happen every year is the Summerfest. Obviously everything was canceled in COVID times, but it has been back. So Summerfest actually I'm not quite sure if you guys are very aware of it, but Summerfest is like a concert series that they do in New Mexico. They had the first one in North Domingo Park. It was really big. So they have like two different, they have the stage and then they have a little tent area for like vendors. So they have like a food vendor area, and also they had like products. So people had like jewelry and all that stuff in those. And then they also had a area for, you know, people that wants to drink beer and wine for the 21 and up demographic.
Nice.
It was really fun because it was like on the North Domingo Park. I don't know if you guys have been there.
I haven't been there yet.
They do the Indian Festival there too, which I have been. It's really big. They have the big stage. We kind of were a little bit more on the other side.
Yeah.
Like where the trees are, trying to like stay in the shade because it was really, really hot that day. But there wasn't that many people at the beginning.
Yeah.
But I think it was just because it was so hot.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah, because like we went, like it was supposed, like it starts at 5 o'clock. So the act starts at 5 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And the gates, I mean, there's no gate. Yeah. But like, you know, it technically opens at 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
And then like, I think till 10. So, but like, I think around 8 o'clock is when it started to get a little bit more busier, when it started to get a little bit more dark. And like, this is my cute outfit.
That's so cute.
I went out, like all the, I love it. Cause like all the little girls were like coming to me and I'm like, I love your outfit. You know? So it's just like, and I mean, any reason for me to dress up, I will dress up.
Oh yeah.
And I'm making the most out of this wig. I've already worn it like 3 times
Yeah.
And it will get worn again. But it's really cool because like people, like, cause like I have a friend of ours that actually has been to Summerfest before. She thought that it was going to be just like one kind of like, you know, theme of music, like one genre. But no, they played like one of the bands that was really, really cool is like a reggae Mexican fusion.
All right.
That was like, I was just like blown away. But like, I feel like it's like music now was like so much blending. But it was so cool to hear like reggae with like a Mexican fusion feel and also like Spanish, you know, so it's like,
that is pretty cool. Yeah, that sounds like something good to jam to.
Yeah, and they have jazz, and like they had like so many different type of music that they were playing. So like they have like different acts, so that was really cool. And you know, for people that want to just snacks and eat food.
See, that's awesome. I like the diversity.
They also had food trucks. That's why I forgot about that. So like they had vendors, and they had food trucks, and they had like cotton candy and popcorn and food trucks. Like the Baskin Robbins food truck was there, and I was like,
"Wow, what's going on?"
Wow! So they had popcorn.
Yeah, they had
okay. You're
those,
speaking my language.
Yeah, popcorn, kettle corn, like, but like they had like they definitely had like everything for everyone.
Because
like I had like a Indian curry. There was like an Indian food truck there. There was some burgers. There was some kebabs. There were like there was a lot of food trucks and a lot of food. And it was really fun. I mean, I also brought, like, my own little cooler and, like, charcuterie stuff and snacks because I really didn't want to spend that much money.
Yeah,
I don't blame you. Honestly, it's so much fun going to these festivals, but once you get in the door, it's like, cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching.
Yeah, it just everything adds up, you know?
Yeah.
And it's, like, it's one of those things where, like, I mean, did I spend money? Yes. I mean, it's not like I did not spend money. I still spend money. But, like, I spend less a year, not really less, but it's like maybe like $10 less. You
know? Which, you know, I'm like that too. Like, okay, when I go to like festivals or anything, I would rather spend money on the merchandise because I know I can take that with me.
Yeah.
If I eat, I'm like, it's just gone.
Yeah. Well, the also hard thing about that too, when you go to festivals, is like the food trucks and stuff there that you haven't so tried tempting. Before. You know what I mean? Because mm-hmm. you're just like, oh, I haven't seen this food truck before. Or like, I haven't like tried this fusion thing
all
before.
The smells.
You know, like I love bubble tea. And I'm like, I already have a bubble tea place. But do I buy bubble tea when I'm on a festival?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like a bubble tea truck. Yeah. You know, it's like, should I really buy bubble tea here? Probably not.
Yeah.
But do like, I? But the question is, do I though? I do. You know?
Yeah, and then when you go to the checkout, it's like $12 a drink, and you're like, oh, what the heck?
And then you get a tip, you know, or something.
It's not bad
today. Yeah. So, but it's like, it's one of those things, like, it's really hard. Because, like I said, it's like, I brought, like, so much snacks and drinks. Like, I mean, I also brought, because I am over 21. It's only for 21 plus people.
Yeah, I think we're all over 21. Yeah.
So, like, we did have mimosas. I am extra. I brought, like, champagne glasses. And like we had a mimosa moment, you know, but like, you know, it's just like, I also like where the Summerfest are, because they also have one that's coming up. It's the one downtown where they close Central.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
That one is a little bit harder because it's not really a park.
Yeah.
So you don't really have any place to kind of just like sit down.
Mm.
You can sit down, but it's like asphalt.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like sidewalk.
Yeah,
you know, it's not grass or like trees, you know.
Oh, that's good.
For sure.
Yeah. I mean, but what I like about that is it's where the area where the restaurants are.
Mm-hmm.
So usually there's like a stage right in front of Metucci's.
Yeah.
So we go to the outside
that's
seating.
Pretty cool.
So like we see the stage, hear the stage, but we're eating Italian food.
Ooh.
So, you know.
You
so
found the like, cheat code.
Yeah. So, like, that's what I usually go with, like, a group. I know where it is. I will see you guys the information.
Ooh.
Okay.
We should go.
That sounds really good.
It is on a Saturday, so I know you guys are a little bit busy, but maybe we can meet up after.
Ooh, yeah.
You know, I'll make the reservation for the restaurant.
Okay. So like,
I'll get that set up. But, like, what I love about these, because, like, they're all, like, different locations. So, like, a couple, like, one on the east side, one on the west side, and then one downtown. So, like, whatever your flavor is. Because some people are very downtown hips. You know, the kiddies, the youngins, the cool people.
Honestly, you know? That's where, like, Knob Hill is, like, kind of my go-to.
Exactly.
It's, like, that teen
and
early 20. You just have, like, nostalgic stores.
Yeah.
Like, the record store.
Yeah, and because, like, it's right where the businesses are. So, like, you can walk around.
Mm-hmm.
And they have three stages.
Oh, that's awesome.
So, like, you can be whatever stage you want.
Mm-hmm.
Or, like, go to a different stage or, like, you know, meet other people.
Mm-hmm.
Or, like, if you're with your friends and that's not your type of music, you can just be like, okay, well, I see you, like, after the
just
next
Just go to song. Another stage.
You know what I mean? Or go to the next act. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think that's why, like, that one is, like, definitely one of the busier ones.
Mm-hmm.
And also, like, the Mexican people with, like, the ice cream and the snack things are there. I love that shenanigan. I always do bring cash for that one.
Uh-huh.
I gotta get my ice cream. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to call, like that orange, like chips thing that they put vinegar in.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
Yeah, those are delicious.
Those are so good.
And they are good.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So like they go there. So they're there the whole day.
Yeah.
So I'm literally just like ice cream all day.
Yeah.
All day.
Mm. Sounds fun. That's a good atmosphere.
Yeah. So like, and then I bring like I have like a little. I don't know if you guys seen it, like the folding chair, like the circle one, and then it expands.
Mm-hmm.
I have it because it's like a little baggy, and that's what I use for like sitting down.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm lazy.
Yeah.
And I'm
like,
I do stuff like that too, you know.
I bring my own chair everywhere.
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
But that's why it's nice when some of the vendors, you know, the taco trucks do bring their own.
Yeah, and the
table
food trucks.
Yeah,
so like the food trucks are also there.
Yeah.
They're like on the corner streets
because
they can't park where the area is. And then the low riders are in the middle. So people bring their low riders. So, like, because, like, it's, like, a very, like, New Mexican feel.
Yeah.
So, like, it's really cool to
nice
see, like, you know,
up.
Local cars.
Yeah.
I think last year, because, like, you know, because of COVID and everything, last year was, like, really big. So, like, they went all out. Because, like, now they have, like, the jumping castles and stuff for the kids.
Mm-hmm.
So, those are always fun. Because, like, a lot of, like, the Summerfest festival things are, like, more catered to like adults.
That's true.
But the one in the downtown is more catered to like families because like they have like the jumping castles for the kids. They have like kind of like the arcade games and stuff. So
Bussy.
So cool. Yeah, but I like the fact that like they have like three different locations and a lot of them are like local acts and also outside acts.
Oh nice.
And I was actually thinking like because Marcus here is an artist and will be playing the guitar for us fairly soon, you should definitely inquire because they hire local acts. And like I think like a lot of people when they listen to music, we definitely know acts that are like outside of New Mexico because I feel like they're more convenient and they're on social media and stuff. Mm-hmm. But sometimes we do forget like local acts that are coming from here. So to like learn local acts and know local acts that like actually like in our backyard, we could actually see them and meet them and, you know, support them is really cool.
Exactly.
You know, so because like sometimes we do forget that like, oh, they live here. You know, like to like actually like know that like, oh, there are artists here in New Mexico, in Albuquerque.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? And they do like local stuff and follow them. I think that's really cool.
For sure.
You know what I mean? For like the culture for New Mexico and like actually like trying to like expose local acts is really neat.
And you know, I love going to weddings that have live music. That's always so much fun.
I know.
I'm like, forget the DJ, brings the musicians in.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm gonna hit the dance floor.
Yeah.
Dance it up. Yeah. I agree.
There is something more personal with like, I mean, don't get me wrong, I love music, I love DJs, but like, you know, like live music is so cool.
Yeah, it is.
Because like, even with like the DJs in like when you do it like live, it just have like a different feel. I mean, music is music, but like when you have like a guitar and the drums and like, you know, the different like I remember like a friend of mine is saying like she just discovered a cappella and I'm like, that was like 10 years ago. It was cute. You know what I mean? Like, I'm so glad that, like, you discovered it. You know what I mean? But, like, to have, like, those kind of acts, like, seeing it live in person is even more, like, crazy.
Yeah.
You know? Because, like, I remember when I saw the Ting Tings. Like, she was singing and playing the little piano organ thing and doing the guitar. And she had, like, a synthesizer, those things that, like, you push on your feet. And I'm just like, she's like a one-man show.
Is that the band that sings That's Not My Name?
Yes.
Sure, yeah.
So, and then she has, like, a bandmate, a guy.
Yeah.
And also does, like, a they do, like, different instruments.
Yeah.
And, like I said, it's just, like, I think it's cool to actually, like, see them live. Because, like I said, music is music. But, like, to see, like, an act. I mean, that's why we go to concerts.
Exactly. For sure, you know. Right. And it's so true. And especially if you're playing something live, it takes energy to produce that in the moment, you know. Mm-hmm. Instead of, rather than having something recorded.
And perfected.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah, so you're so exposed when you play live.
It's raw.
Know? Yeah, it's raw.
Right? You know? Because, like, you're in the moment. You're experiencing it together. It is also like a community thing, right? Because like you're in that moment with these people who's experiencing the same thing, seeing the same things, hearing the same things in this particular moment of time, you know? And I think that's like really cool. And then now Marcus is gonna give us a little bit of performance.
Okay.
And also businesses, and also he's also offering like guitar lessons. We will put his information fairly soon so you can contact him. So if there's any places that wants to do live music or live shows or even people that are doing Summerfest or any local events that would like to have like musicians and, you know, live music, you can contact Marcus through this information and you can also contact our show.
Yes, you can. So I play classical guitar. So the piece I'm going to play, it's called El Marabino. Marabino is like a sort of dialect that they speak in Venezuela. And the composer is Antonio Lauro. It's a classical guitar piece, pretty popular, little waltz, and I'm gonna play it for you right now. It's one of my favorite pieces. Thank you. Thank you for listening. Yes, appreciate it.
Anybody would like to contact Marcus, he does all the events for businesses and also for personal events, weddings or anything. Please contact him. He would love to, you know, help you guys with and vice versa. And that's how amazing music.
Thank you guys. Thank
and that's
you.
Why, like, I think, like, live music is definitely a thing. And I love it because, like, you know, you people get to dance to the music. Those mm-hmm. are always fun.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, it's so fun to dance. And also when musicians get to sort of interact with the crowd, too. You know, and like I said, it is all about energy, you know, positive, good energy. You can feel that coming back from the people as well. And I think when people give an artist or a musician good, positive energy, you actually get more out of them, and they do better as well, too. You know, and so we definitely appreciate that, yeah. You know.
Because I think it just becomes personal because, like, you see it in person, right, for both, for the viewers and the artists. Like, you see, like, how they're reacting, singing to your songs when you're, like, that big already, you know what I mean? Because, mm-hmm. like, I remember, like, a lot of, like, the K-pop groups, they were saying how, like, it's very interesting. Because even with the language barrier, to hear your own language
mm-hmm.
yeah,
from these different countries, when they don't even speak it, they just know it by the songs.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's also, like, you know, bridging the culture, the language barrier, you know, through music, and I think music is just amazing like that.
Exactly, and, you know, earlier, you know, hinting at what you said earlier about supporting local musicians and artists, too, I mean, it could also even be for your own benefit, you know, you never know who's going to get big, you know, and it's also a good time to collaborate with them, get some autographs, mm-hmm. you know, get some photos, because we have had a lot of really great acts come out of New Mexico as well, too.
I think so, too, and, like, now that, like, you know, music is, like, you know, in media and everywhere now, you know, it's much more convenient and it's much more accessible,
mm-hmm.
right? And mm-hmm. I think that's why, like, it's amazing. And to have, like, you know, I like the fact that, like, you know, New Mexico and the city of Albuquerque actually, like, offers, you know, this kind of entertainment. Because, like, not everybody can, like, afford to go to a concert now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
That's true.
Like, and also, like, you know, depending on the age, like, the children, you know, teens and kids, like, they can't afford it,
mm-hmm.
first of all, some of them don't. And then of them are, like, usually, like, not age appropriate.
Yeah.
Right? Sure. So to, like, expose them to, like, live music at a very such age is, like, mm-hmm. I think it's, like, it's, and it's free. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, the fact that, like, it's accessible to everyone.
Yeah.
I definitely love that idea.
Yeah. I agree, you know. And on the flip side of that, too, there's a lot of other children who want to be musicians or want to be artists, mm-hmm. but it's also not as accessible or they can't. It's hard to see it as a realistic profession to pursue, you know?
And to see, like, somebody that looks like you or even lives in the same place as you and see that it's possible, right?
Exactly.
It's all about, like, visibility.
For sure.
You know what I mean? So I think that's really cool. And saying of, like, visibility mm-hmm. in media, I think a really good hot topic today is that, you know, because, like, of, like, phones and cameras and everything is mm-hmm. accessible, you know, people can video you,
mm-hmm.
and it'll be in the internet forever.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, it's not just, like, the Karens of the world.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just celebrity.
Yeah.
It's also, like, us. Like, our information, you know, when you go to a concert or you are somewhere public, your picture, you are in some stranger's background.
Yeah.
So true.
Yeah.
Forever.
Forever, yeah.
So right?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because, like, I remember I was watching a video of this influencer where, like, she usually Photoshop people out of her picture
mm-hmm.
because, like, it's usually, you know, it's much more nice because, like, she's the focus of the picture.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But then she saw a couple in her background that was, like, proposing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this guy was proposing to his girlfriend. And she left them.
Mm-hmm.
She left the couple that was proposing.
Mm. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's the thing. It's just like those couple decided to propose in public.
Yeah.
In a very, like, it's their personal event, but it's in the public. So people are probably, like, their proposal is probably in a lot of people's background pictures.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, like, you know how, like, you know, when you're a model, like, you mm-hmm. sign away certain rights. You
sign a waiver. And,
you know what I mean? You sign a waiver, but then when you're, because, like, technically when you're in public, it's public domain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right? So, like, mm-hmm. you become, like, in somebody else's video or, you know what I mean? So, like, our mistakes,
mm-hmm.
like the Karens of the world,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean, becomes, like, amplified.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right? Because now you can go viral for doing something good and doing something really bad.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this
right?
is true.
And then it also becomes of, like, you know, what is the timeline? What is the cutoff date of you being a Karen?
Yeah.
You know
yeah.
what I mean?
Yeah.
Because then, like, the personal mistake that you would have done in a personal matter now becomes public. Because, you know, we're all human.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, and when you're like, constantly under the spotlight, it's very easy to say the wrong thing, you know? And we're all... Everybody could be guilty of saying something that could be twisted you know, or manipulated by a camera.
Yeah.
See, that's why I, like, when I think about it, I'm glad I didn't have, like, phones and everything wasn't that popular when I was in high school. Because, like, now everything's more detrimental. Like, my sister, when she went to school, which is, like, a few years difference from me, there was a kid, and girls sent him photos, like, personal photos. And when he hit 18 and he got caught with all these photos, he got tried as an adult.
Oh.
So... And those girls' photos, he was sending them out, you know?
Mm. And another thing also is, like, there is a lot of that because, like, there's a lot of, like, victim blaming when it comes. I mean, we can talk about this for forever, you know, because, like, you know, people were just like, well, you know, they shouldn't have, like, sent this, like, incriminating photos of themselves. But I'm just like, yeah, but you have to think about it, too. It's like, these are intimate photos of somebody who's in a relationship.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, we were doing this, except, like, we didn't have the technology at the time.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know what I mean? You know, so it's like, you know, we were also documenting our lives through a VHS tape.
Yeah.
Or a CD. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But the difference now is, like, you can literally be in a TikTok and go viral for, like, billions of views that can be reposted and reposted and now on internet forever.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, like, we're all human. Like, there's going to be times where, like, we're weak. You know, maybe we're not in the best, you know, emotional state. So we act out on things. I mean, I'm not saying that there's no consequences for your actions.
Yeah, for
and there's always different sides of the story because those things do come out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And there are a thing of, like, if you're not problematic, you know what I mean? Like, there wouldn't be anything on you.
Yeah.
But, like, you can't be perfect 24/7.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
So, like, at what point... You know, do we do a cutoff date on, like, okay, yeah, I was a Karen, like, in 2009, you know, by, like, 2023, can, like, not be a Karen anymore? Because also, you turn into memes. You turn into gifs, you know what I mean? You know?
Yeah.
Like, you turn into so many different things.
That's, like, when I was following The Bachelor, and I was following all the way up to, like, the final season, and then they had the recap.
Mm-hmm.
So, this guy ended up picking one of the main girls, her name's Rachel, and she's like in her 20s, you know, but from where she comes from is like more Midwest area, so they're more racially
conservative,
you know, and so they got together and everything, and then months after he picked her, you know, those photos of her going to like a plantation house, like a plantation party house, resurfaced, and they're very racist, you know, face like controversial photos, and that actually split them up for a while. Yeah, so they were like apart for like a good 6 months to a year, and then they end up reconnecting, but it was when she was like 19 years
but
old.
And that's the thing, it's just like people just think about it like it just in the celebrities like point of view. I've talked about this with everyone, like even with like a celebrity, because like I was like in the Comic-Con and I was luckily have met Margaret Moreau. She was Jessie from Queen of the Dam and in Mighty Ducks. Where like, you know, when you're in the public eye, everything is scrutinized. But that's not true. You don't have to be in the public eye. You can be a regular person and be in the public eye because of social media. And then if you have that perfect thing, like you're catchy and, you know, like what I mean, good or bad, you can go viral for anything, literally anything. And you can lose your job. You can lose your family. You can lose your kids. You can, you know what I mean? Those actually have some really, really hard life repercussions. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not saying that some people don't deserve to be fired.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then, like, our personal, internal, emotional, mental state now becomes a public debate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. When sometimes, like, you know, somebody's, you know what I mean? Like, somebody just died and then you check into the hotel, you know. I'm not saying that, like, being a racist is an excuse. It's not any excuse whatsoever. Drinking is also not an excuse. Yep. You know, I was drinking and I say things that I don't mean, blah, 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 blah. Like, there is.
Yeah.
But like I said, it's like, you can't be perfect 24/7. Yeah. I have a joke with my husband that, like, mm-hmm. I can run for office because I have no controversy.
Mm-hmm.
Because I grew up in millennial time. I do have Facebook, mm-hmm. but yeah. I have nothing on my Facebook that will incriminate me.
Yeah.
My friends, however. Because the thing is, like, when we met,
yeah.
we went to, like, a friend of mine's wedding.
Yeah.
And he tried to dig some dirt on me. Because mm-hmm. it was like, I wanted to know what you were. And then, you know, come to find out, he was like, well, you have dirt on all your friends. I'm like, yeah. Because I was sober most of the time. And videos. I actually have physical pictures of my friends doing stupid crap.
Yeah.
So they can't say anything on me because I have things on them. Like, it's in a photo album my house. It's not on the internet somewhere. Like, it's an actual physical thing, you know? And that's the thing that I'm trying to say. Yeah. It's just like, when is your mistake just a mistake and not a lifetime mistake?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because, you know, people are allowed to change.
Yeah.
You know, we're allowed to grow. And, like, exactly. you know, you are a product of your environment.
I agree.
You know what I mean? Because, mm-hmm. like, when I first met my husband, you know, I am more of liberal thinking. And, mm-hmm. like, you know, but, like, he also, you know, grew up in a very religious Christian belief. So, you know, I mean, you know, I have this joke of just like, if I have none, you were a Republican, we would have never dated.
Yeah.
You know, that kind of thing. You know, but, like, of course I have friends that are Republican. Because, you know, at the end of the day, politics is only a small part of you.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
I mean,
it does and it doesn't.
Yeah.
But we also have to remember that, like, we're also all human and people.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We should know each other as a person. Yeah. I mean, if you are affecting the lives of my friends and my family, of course not.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But to the mm-hmm. point that I also want to know you as a person, right?
Exactly.
So, like, you're also a product of your environment. So, like, if you grew up in a conservative family
mm-hmm.
who do believe in, like, misogynistic, racist stuff as a child, that's what you follow.
Yeah.
But then, you know, then you grew up, you move, you go to college, and then you change. You're also allowed to change. You're also allowed to make mistakes.
Yeah, I believe that, too.
You know what I mean?
I believe that. And that was, like, the controversial with Rachel because she grew up in that type of environment, mm-hmm. you know? And then when she got out of that environment, she changed, you know?
Yeah.
So I was like, I was so happy that when they got back together.
Yeah. Well, also, like I said, it's like we were all children once.
Yeah.
You know, and also, like, just because we grew up, mm-hmm. that doesn't mean we grow up.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like,
that's true.
There are some adults out there with, like, children minds and hearts and adult bodies.
Yeah.
You know? And, you know, that's all we are. We're, like, children in adult bodies.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I still call my mom sometimes because I don't know what to do. You know? Like, I'm like, oh, what to do with this, you know? You know? So, like, you know, and I think it's hard because, like, you see this, like, you know,
mm-hmm.
you know, like, with Justin Bieber kind of thing, you know, he was a celebrity and he did a lot of things when he was, like, you know, abusing alcohol and drugs and everything, you know, and then now that he's, like, older and married and, like, you know, like, mm-hmm. at the end of the day, like, when is enough punishment in a way?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right? Because, like, people do change. I mean, some people don't. I mean, I know that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But most people do grow.
Yeah.
Because they do, you know what I mean? Because, like, those kind of things, when it happens to you and you become, like, the ridicule and you mm-hmm. become, you know, when you become on the other side.
Yeah.
And people are, like, also, like, people get threatened with their lives. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, those things do happen. Like, when people get canceled, like, with the whole, like, you know, Selena and, what's her name? Like, Justin Bieber's wife. I can't even remember her
name. Oh, Hailey.
Hailey. Like, you know, she was just like, you know, people are, like, threatening my life. They're, like, you know, coming to my house. You know, there's, like, life ramifications that are serious things.
Yeah.
You know, like, you don't want that. Like, you don't want to be stalked.
When it's too far.
When it becomes too far that, like, it's affecting your mental state.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then your children and then your family gets affected. You know what I mean? When they're,
That's like, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cut you off. Do you remember that movie Bling Ring?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's like that, like with those teens.
With Alexis,
those teenagers in mm-hmm. high school that were, you know, breaking into celebrities' home for mm-hmm. fun. They broke into Paris Hilton I don't know how many times because she would constantly post her location. They would just, like, as soon as she left, they would just go raid mm-hmm. her stuff. And then they went into Orlando Bloom's house, and then that's when they get caught, when they got caught up with the video and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of them had got some serious jail time. because mm-hmm. of that.
Yeah. And also, like, they grew up now, they have family and yep. stuff. And, you know, like, and they're always known as those kids and those yeah. people. But, like, you know, they were children. Mm-hmm. They were kids. Like, they were so young. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. I'm not saying that, like, I did stuff like that when I was young.
Yeah.
But mm-hmm. I know I've done some stupid stuff.
Yeah.
That, like, didn't need to be in social media.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And, you,
yeah.
you know, like, you know, at that age, our brain is not completely developed.
Yeah, I
You know
agree.
What I mean? We do some reckless mm-hmm. ass shenanigans.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But then now, you know, with the social media, even if you don't post things, somebody will post things of you.
Exactly.
You know what yeah. I mean? Even without your consent. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm trying to say. There's, like, the privacy issue and the consent yep. issue. You know, where is the line that we need to make when it comes to this stuff? But like I said, it's like we can talk about this for hours.
Exactly. Yeah, well, and it's tough too because you have a good point. You know, it's like the technological development, it's always right in front of where the laws can keep up with it, you know. And so, because like back in the day, and when I say that, I mean, you know, before the internet, before cell phones, maybe even the time of TV just and newspapers, you know, if you were going to write something that was false about somebody, you know, like defamation or, you know, slander, whatever, you could get sued or you could actually go to jail for something like that, you know, because you can't be writing false statements about people, you know, mm-hmm. or threatening them. But today a lot of people get away with it because we just don't have enough people to mm-hmm. Moderate that, you know. And then like with the child celebrities, you know, still being, you know, they're children, they do these things, and now they're still under the spotlight for what they did back in the day. And I think this is also kind of like, you know, if we could go back to like a couple hundred years ago when a child, say, became like the next emperor of a kingdom or the mm-hmm. next queen or something like that, they would spend a lot of their childhood, you know, training for that, you know, learning what to say, what not mm-hmm. to say, how to show face, how to save face, you know, what, how to treat the people and talk to the people. And I think a lot of these child celebrities, you know, they're pushed into it.
They just rush into fame, yeah.
Yeah, they're pushed into it, and then they don't know what to say or what to do, and they're just regular kids with a lot of money, and it's a perfect, and I think perhaps they do that on purpose, you know, because it creates some sort of controversy or some sort of drama.
I know, but at the end of the day, they're children.
Yeah, exactly. They're sacrificing them, you know, and it's very sad, you know, it's unfortunate.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know some celebrities, obviously, we know and respect them, you know, because they're wise or they have information to offer. And they're smart. They know they're not going to be at the bar, you know, taking selfies with people.
I know, but, like, not all kids are like that.
They don't know that, exactly.
Even I was, like, a really, really good kid. But like I said, it's like I've done some dumb stuff that shouldn't be. But like I said, it's just like, you know, look at, like, Drew Barrymore and Robert Downey Jr., mm-hmm. you know, who was, like, you know, look at their lives and then now look at them now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like they've grown. They've, like, done so many good things. And it's like I said, it's just like, I think it's just harder because even when you don't do it yourself, somebody else can be doing it for you.
Yeah.
And it's like Mark Wahlberg, too.
Yeah.
No, it's tough for
these
kids.
They all have, like, a criminal history.
Yeah. So it's just like from one hot topic to another.
Yeah.
We will now deal with drama. When I said drama, I mean Reddit. So, this is interesting because it's couples and friends. So.
Ooh,
okay. Am I the a-hole for telling my husband's female friend he might be your best friend, but you're not his?
Ooh, okay.
That's a little bit like, Long story short, my husband has one of those female friends. I'll call her Sarah. Her and I got along fine. But every once in a while, she'll make a comment or sit a little too close or touch him a lot or compete with me on how close they are or how well she knows him. She's one in the big group of about 11 friends. I've talked to my husband about her several times, but it's so many added up micro actions that it's hard to tell her off for one singular thing without looking crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this past weekend, the group of friends got together for the first time since we're now all boosted. My husband and I eloped a few weeks ago, and this was the first time most of us were seeing us since. Sarah came right up and got in our face as the group was congratulating us to tell my husband how disappointed she was in him for not telling her about the ceremony, not inviting her, not even sending her a photo. He told her nobody except our parents knew. Nobody was invited, and we don't have our professional photos back. This girl starts sobbing. How could he do this to her? That she wanted him to be her man of honor when she gets married. She's single. And he didn't even invite her to his. And their friendship now needs some serious TLC to recover. Mm. This is in front of a whole group. I couldn't take it anymore, and he said, he might be your best friend, but you're not his. And this was between me and him. You were not even a consideration. There were frosty oohs from the crowd. And she left the house. The crowd is split. There were all my husband's friends before I came into the picture. Mm. And something it was uncalled for and that I should have let my husband handle it. I was mad in the moment, but now I don't know. Too far. I told my husband's female friend she wasn't his best friend and embarrassed her in front of all of her friends. Am I the a-hole?
No, because if you had dressed it to your husband already, and he didn't really took it into consideration of talking to his friend, then no.
It's one of those things I always do this whenever we watch shows or like things, and then my husband's do like, I gotta go. Because I'll be like, men, and they'll be like, I gotta go, you know?
Yeah.
Because it is like one of those things, because it's hard to be the significant other of like a group of friends that already friends before you.
Mm-hmm.
Because you keep them, and then some of them, you lose them.
Yeah, so true.
You know, and it's more common now to have opposite sex friends.
Yeah.
I mean, I've had some, mm-hmm. but I did have some things, once I got married kind of thing of like, oh, why are you still hanging out with guys? You're already a married person kind of thing. And I'm just like, I'm not doing anything. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And when you meet me, you know I'm married. Mm-hmm. I'm not shady like that. I don't flirt with other people.
Yeah.
You know, I don't give other men an idea that I'm flirting with them or I'm even available in the slightest. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And we don't have any trust issues.
Yeah.
I travel by myself for months without my husband. You know, we definitely don't have trust issues when it comes to that kind of stuff. But I can kind of see how it could be, especially now with the day and age with social media and all that stuff, you know? So and it's also hard because I mean, we can't say we don't get jealous. I'm not, because the thing is, I'm not the jealous type, but my husband is. And it's hard because, I don't know. I don't know what it's like to be that because I've never been the jealous type.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying that I've never been jealous. It has happened.
Mm-hmm.
And then I come to find out that he was cheating with me in the first place. So it wasn't wasn't jealous. It's just I knew something was wrong.
Yeah.
It was a gut feeling.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't a matter of a jealousy thing. It's more of a cheating thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's not anybody's in the wrong. I think this becomes of a possessive kind of atmosphere. Right? Because you do have friends that are possessive.
Yeah, it's so true.
You know what I mean? You have friends that are, I do have a couple friends where, they get jealous that I hang out with other friends, right? And you're I'm extroverted.
That's what I'm the same.
You know what I mean? Because
yeah,
I do have, some introverted friends that, get jealous. And you're like, why are you hanging out? I'm like, because it's not your thing. You don't like these events. You know what I mean?
You have friends for different occasions and different events. Yeah.
It's like, if I invited you, you would say no. So what do? Go by myself?
Yeah,
you know?
Heck no.
I gotta go to my other friends that do these kind of events.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? Because it's vice versa.
Yeah.
You know, but they do get a little bit possessive.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying that she's in the wrong.
Yeah.
You know, it's just it definitely a spur of the moment emotional stuff.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, for me, if he didn't address anything to her, you know, her friend or his friend or whatever, I would feel some type of trust issue now, because I'm why is she still coming on to you really hard and just wanting to be around you all the time and wanting to come to our wedding after we've already said that we're eloping, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I would be are you sending some type of signal? And if you are, you need to shut that down right now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think I said, it's just this is also it's also hard because it's in public, you know, it was in their group.
Mm-hmm.
But because the microaggressions has added up so much
that
eventually it's the straw that breaks the camel kind of thing, right?
For sure.
Eventually she just got tired of it. Mm-hmm. It wasn't a conversation anymore. It's just a floodgate.
Yeah.
This bee.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I can't stand you anymore.
Or maybe she was just oh, okay, I'm fine with it, you know, and after you say I'm fine after so many times and you're bottling it up, you know, and you're in the wrong place at the wrong time, then bam.
Yeah, I mean, you're the guy. So, like, how would you feel if your significant other do this in front of your friends?
Yeah, so, I mean, in that moment, obviously, it wouldn't feel good. But I do agree with what Rhea said, too, and also what you guys said about, you know, basically creating boundaries so that way in the first place, so that way you don't have all this resentment building up, and then it just explodes. Because I think sometimes when people make comments or they say things like that, or it's like the spur of the moment emotion, it's been building up the whole time, and a lot of times the other person has no idea that you even felt that way or that somebody felt that way, you know? And so, yeah, they probably should have, because a lot of couples do things that I would never do or that probably we would never do, and that's fine as long as they have some sort of understanding about it.
Because it's a case-by-case basis, especially when you're a couple. And I think, like, I think that's the hard part, too. It's just like, like I said, it's like when the, one of those things, I'm like, men. And then my husband will be like, I'm going to exit right here. Because also, like, you know what I mean? Like, it's his friends. Yeah. He should have, like, asserted that boundary right away.
For sure, I agree.
You know what I mean? Because it's like, it is really hard because I've been in this relationship where you're like, you know, like, you need to say something because I can't say something.
Yeah, exactly.
Because if I say something,
then you look crazy.
Then I become the villain.
Yeah. And then it gets confusing, you know?
And that's what happened exactly now. It's like, you know, it just blew up in front of everyone. Yeah. What do you do?
I know.
You know? Because, like, she's also allowed to have emotions and be a person.
And she's, like, trying to save face at the same time.
Exactly.
And, like, it's one of those things where, like, if she doesn't want to apologize, I can understand where she's coming from. You know what I mean? Because, like, you know, you're kind of justified in not apologizing. But then, like, you don't want to be the villain. So, like, you're just apologizing just for the sense of apologizing. Then your friends are like, oh, she's just apologizing because she doesn't want to be. You know what I mean? Where do you, like, how do you even know how to act at this point now?
And then, you know, it's also like his friend had no respect, you know, for their relationship. You know, if she had any respect, she wouldn't have been coming on to him in the first place. Yeah. If it was just a friend, you know.
But also, it's really hard because it's also perspective.
Yeah. Exactly. Because, and if she was allowing that.
Because it's not just, like, boundaries, but, like, I'm, like, I have learned, but, like, I'm definitely more, not handsy, but, like, I do hug, you know, but, like, I have, like, definitely, as I get older, learn how to navigate that kind of stuff. Because, you know, when your guy friend do date, it is a territory kind of thing.
Yeah.
It's harder because you don't want to be coming up across as, like, that woman.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because you also, like, want to keep that friendship, because I have lost guy friends.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they did feel some type of way. Not because it's my fault or their fault.
Yeah.
It's just complicated.
It is what it is, yeah.
Yeah.
For sure, you know.
So.
But I agree. I think maybe the most important thing is just to have that understanding, set the boundaries, and then respect the boundaries. Now, in that situation, maybe if they had already had boundaries and talked about it, and then someone violated it, then maybe that would be an issue.
Communication is really, really important,
it really
especially
is.
In a relationship.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's so true. You know? And, you know, like, when it comes to that, like, hanging out with, like, the opposite sex, like, I know everybody's different, you know, but usually it would be, like, a group thing, you know, like, it, like I said, it varies. Like, for me now, I probably wouldn't just go hang out with another guy by myself, but it, if it was our friend, we would all hang out. Like, and then I have my sister. They have female friends, too. They both do, and they all just hang out in a group.
Yeah. You know? Well, I do. Like, I actually do hang out with my girlfriends. Like, we go to movies together. And Ryan doesn't care because he knows he's like, you know, there's nothing, I would never, you know what I mean? Because we've been together for 15 years.
Yeah, you guys
have
been together a long time.
Yeah, so
being
it's
in
like,
a fresh, like in a new relationship.
Also, that's what it is too. Especially like, when you just got married.
Yeah. Oh, see, that's different.
For sure.
Yeah, so like also varies too, if they're in a new relationship or if they've been in a long-term relationship. Because like for me, I see like being in a new relationship, establishing trust first.
Yeah.
And then, you know, like, okay, we can go do, hang
it's
out
so
with
fresh.
Whoever.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Makes
but
sense.
Like long term, you know, it varies. You're
boundaries,
like, okay, I have
people.
Trust, you know? You're like, I have trust.
Boundaries.
Yeah.
But like, what do you guys think? What do you viewers think? You know, did you guys like had this drama? Feel about the drama?
Yeah.
If you guys want to follow us in our social media, we are in TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. If you want to contact us, if you're a business, if you want to sponsor, or if you want to come to the show and be one of our guests. Or, you know, if you want to showcase your products or your business, please contact us. But for now, we will see you guys next week. Bye.